My name is Dave Armstrong. I'm currently at the University of Western Ontario. I'm a political scientist, and my work is largely on methodology, mostly measurement, although I do some work on state repression and measuring democracy and protest policing, things like that, too. The Regression 3 course really has as its objective moving people beyond the theoretical things that they learn in a linear models class in their department to more interesting and hopefully useful applied extensions. Particularly, we focus on graphical presentation of model results, along with lots of ways for dealing with problems of nonlinearity with various levels of flexibility, methods for dealing with other common problems like heteroscedasticity, outliers and influential data. And then at the end of the course, we focus on a few topics that usually aren't covered in regression classes, like mixture models and imputation and sensitivity to non-ignorability problems, model selection and averaging. The syllabus for the course looks really daunting because there's a lot of reading. I hope the syllabus is a reasonably comprehensive picture of what people would have to read when they go back if they're really interested in a topic. So if you look at the syllabus, it looks really challenging, but I don't assume that people will come to class having read everything on the syllabus for that day. It's more a tool for self-learning when you get back. The course has 3 homework sets, along with 3 labs. The labs don't require turning in anything, but they largely mirror the sorts of things that students will be doing in the homework. The homeworks are all applied, so they're all in R, and I essentially give participants a data set and ask them to answer a handful of questions about the data that focus on the readings and work that we've done in class. One of the things we focus on in the Regression 3 course is trying to make your quantitative research more palatable to reviewers. So we focus on this throughout the course. Here's a technique. Here are the ways that you should probably use that technique and the ways that will be most acceptable to reviewers. And here are some things that reviewers probably won't like if you used this particular tool in this particular way. So I think the applied focus really goes beyond just developing a set of tools to being able to employ those tools in your own research in a way that's going to help you get things published. The participants in the Regression 3 course are pretty heterogeneous with respect to their skills and backgrounds and interests. Oftentimes, this is a course that gets taken alongside the Bayes class or the MLE class, so students are oftentimes at that level, although not always. The only real requirement is that you've had a linear models course before. I don't assume that it was especially mathematical or theoretical, only that people have an intuition for the linear model and the sorts of assumptions that we make about the linear model and the sorts of things we can do with it. And in general, people have had that background coming in. There's another requirement that you use R in the course for all of the assignments. People have found that the course is a good way to learn R, so it doesn't require that you know R when you're coming in. And people have been quite successful in the course not knowing R before, and leaving with a set of tools that they can use in the software.